Earlier today, we showed soil sampling on a smaller field. This afternoon, we're going to show soil sampling on a larger field. And you can see this particular field is level and it's nicely prepared for planting, whereas the field we worked with this morning had hills in it. And so we only wanted to sample in the hills. The other thing that this is demonstrating is that random sampling pattern and how random it truly is across a larger field like this. Again, when we had the hills somewhat directed our samples, whereas with this particular sampling pattern, Bob is doing a zigzag pattern so that he gets all of the edges as well as the middle of the field in his soil sampling pattern so that we can assure that we have an accurate indication of what nutrients are available across the entire field rather than just at one or two locations. Once we've collected our soil sample, we need to ensure that all of the little clods that occur from our sample probe are broken up. And in that process of breaking up the clods, we're looking for any impurities, rocks, any debris, anything from the soil surface, like sticks or corn stalks, depending on the field. And you'll notice that they're being thrown out because we don't want them in the sample. Breaking up those clods also starts the process of mixing. Again, we've taken cores from across a very large field, and so we now need to make sure that they're very well mixed, so a little bit of everything that was collected is in the sample. In a sample like this, it's fairly dry. You may want to further dry it before you send it to the test lab. That is one advantage of a paper bag, or sometimes you can lay the sample out on paper if you have the space to do that without it becoming contaminated in your shop, garage, or kitchen. Here is the subsampling of the sample by grabbing a random handful and then mixing it up a little bit more and grabbing another handful, mixing it up again, and so on to fill the bag. And again, to ensure we have, for a field like this, it's no problem ensuring we have at least 2 cups of soil. We never really truly measure it. Use your best guess, but if you have to guess, if you don't think you have enough, make sure you add just a little bit more.